John Lennon, there is no doubt in your mind about the fate of Paul McCartney.
No, it's a joke, isn't it? I mean, Paul isn't dead, you know, and if he was, we would have sold it, you know.
Yes?
Who's Billy Shears?
Billy Shears is an invented name.
I see. Is there a telephone number hidden in that album?
No.
What about the photograph of them all dressed in white tuxedos? They all have red roses.
Paul's got a black carnation.
I see. And a bouquet in his hands.
Right.
Why was that?
Spontaneity again.
No meaning.
No meaning, except that all this may tell you something about McCartney's desire not to conform.
Yes, I think that's it. I agree.
But his nonconformity takes a visual form rather than an active one. In other words, he's less likely to conform on photographs, but he's more likely to conform in his everyday life.
Yes, sir.
Say, John.
What about the Abbey Road album? There's a police van or hearse parked down there. Was that just coincidence?
Well, sure, that would be nothing. That would just be there on the road. It can happen in any environment.
And there's a Volkswagen parked there with the license plate IF28. Would that, Paul, be about 28?
No, we're getting very bizarre now.
These are questions that the kids are asking.
Well, listen. When the human race is having to confront itself at the point that we got to now, 1969, anything can happen, any question can be asked. The more irrelevant it is to the main issue, the better. Cop out. Listen, don't worry about their questions. It's all coincidence. Paul McCartney isn't dead, and the only proof we have that he's alive at this point is that he is. You don't have to do any more than that to prove you're alive, except be alive. You don't have to produce yourself, you don't have to appear on television or speak, or even make a statement. You just have to be alive to make the point, if only to yourself. If people don't wish to be convinced, no amount of denial from Apple will make any difference. But the fact of the matter is that Paul McCartney is alive and well and living in St. John's Wood with his wife and their two children. Beyond that, we really can't emphasize it any further.
Once there was a way.
John Lennon, there is no doubt in your mind about the fate of Paul McCartney.
No, it's a joke, isn't it? I mean, Paul isn't dead, you know, and if he was, we would have sold it, you know. We'd be the first to know.
He's a baby.
He's recording music for Ringo's film and producing Mary Hopkins, so he's very much alive.
Well, how did the rumors affect both of you at this point?
It's a joke to us. It's just a joke.
It's so hard to believe that something like this would be going on, similar to like a James Dean thing.
I can't understand it, because I can understand the James Dean kind of, he still lives crippled but won't come out, you know. I mean, there's some kind of idea you could guess, well, maybe.
Yeah.
But Paul McCartney couldn't die without the world knowing it. The same as he couldn't get married without the world knowing it. It's impossible. He can't go on holiday without the world knowing it. How could he die without everybody knowing it?
Paul McCartney is in England now. Is he at home, or is he on a holiday, or what, John?
He's not on holiday. He's working. He's recording a group called the Ivies, but doing some background music for Ringo's film, The Magic Christian. And I want to be plugging my own stuff, not Paul. So come on, let's get going.
Well, since you're doing a lot of plugging, what is John Lennon up to?
Well, we've got a new single, folks, called Cold Turkey, which is out in your shop shortly. We've all had cold turkey. Don't believe the rumors about this one either. We have a Plastic Ono, that's the Plastic Ono band, Cold Turkey. John and Yoko, Eric Clapton, Klaus Foreman, and Alan White. We have an album, a live album of the Plastic Ono band, which we made in Toronto, Canada, the Rock and Roll Revival, which goes from Blue Suede Shoes into Sheer Madness at the end on the other side. So that's the product, and we also have a new John and Yoko album, which isn't Plastic Ono, which is our more freaky stuff, as you call it. The follow-up to Life of the Lions, which did very well in the States. And it's called The Wedding Album, which consists of an album and lots of pictures, bits, cartoons, drawings, photographs. It's more like a book of the record, and that comes out in about a month. So we have two albums and a single, folks.
Yoko, how do you feel about all this excitement?
Well, I mean, you know, people always seem productive, and actually the thing is that there's so many ideas every day that it's very, very difficult for us to sort of not be constipated, you know, in a sense that there's so much backlog work, you know.
Yeah.
I mean, for us, you know, three albums now at this point, it's not half as much as we want to really bring out, you know.
It'd be nice to be able to produce a single every day and an album once a week, like a color supplement, you know. That'd be really groovy.
Listen, how do you people gain all the ambition, I guess that's the word, and desire, and magnificent, don't you?
Let me tell you, everybody has all the ambition. Everybody's full of ambition.
Yeah.
And it's like, once I gave George the advice on songwriting, to when you start one, finish it. And I think I got the advice from Paul, or working with Paul. But it's like anything, if you have an idea, the best way is to try and do it right away, otherwise you won't do it, and that's called ambition, you know.
Ambition is a wrong word, really, because in case of John, because, you know, I mean, like us all, we're always just doing something natural, you know. And the thing is that it's almost like a physical thing. I mean, you know, if you don't eat, you know, you feel hungry, you know. So you want to eat, it's like that, and it just comes very naturally to him, because like if he has 20 songs in his mind, you know, I mean, he doesn't want to clog that in his mind, just has to get it out, that. So it's more basic than, you know, so-called ambition or anything, not that kind of social state sort of thing.
John, let's go back to talking about the music of the early days, and if you'll permit me to go and address ourselves back to this Paul McCartney rumor and death, if you will. As a matter of fact, let's talk all about this symbolism that's going down in these albums, and address ourselves also to the possibility of death and what you recognize in these albums.
Well, I tell you, I'm not aware of any of them, you see. I only read about them this morning in the paper, and I can't remember them. Something about Sgt. Pepper album cover and Abbey Road album cover.
Yep.
I don't see the connection or how Paul could have been dead. We made Sgt. Pepper 4 years ago. You know.
John, I understand the cover for Cold Turkey is, we might consider that to be symbolic if we get into it.
This is the cover for Cold Turkey,
yeah.
Right? And this is the advert we're using. Now, it's two skulls, which is, what are they called? X-rays that were taken of us in hospital after we had a car crash. Now, by the time this gets to America and the Deep South and the DJ gets it, he'll say, here it is, finally, it's Paul McCartney's skull. Yeah, but it's me and Yoko, actually, and I'm using it to advertise our latest record as the sleeve cover. But when you read that into it, by the time it's got to New Orleans and the DJ's looking for something to talk about, he'll say that this is a sign of death and that Paul is gone, or John and Yoko are dead, you know.
But what about the line on the Sgt. Pepper, I will bury you?
On Sgt. Pepper, the same as the obscenity that was meant to be on a loop at the end of Sgt. Pepper didn't exist.
John, I find it hard to believe that some people are supporting this rumor that's going around here, that if you play some of your records backwards, there are some messages to it, and people can hear these. What do you have to say about the backward movement of these records?
Sure, if you play anything backwards, you're going to get a different connotation, because it's backwards. I have no idea what Beatle records sound like backwards. I never play them backwards.
In other words, you're saying there really is no death wish or any death moment in all these Beatle records.
The connection besides some of these things Paul's dead.
Could some of these things have been like a death rumor to Paul's death back there in 1966?
Well, how did we take the photograph for Abbey Road with me with a beard and looking as I do today, and Paul looking as he does today, walking across the road, when he'd been dead since Pepper? What did we do, stuff him and shave him? You know, or what? How could we do it? I don't understand what it's about at all, you know. Paul isn't dead. We don't often sing or refer to death, I don't think so. And I don't...
What about the Abbey Road thing, John, where the bare feet of Paul McCartney sort of would indicate death to some?
That's the first time I've ever heard of it, you know.